Hi, Mike Redding here. Over the last couple of weeks, there's been a lot written on the internet, in forums, in newspapers, blog posts and so on, about what is Google doing with student data. And so I get a lot of emails from schools asking how to best respond to parents and board members and teachers' concerns. And so I wanted to put together this quick video that talks to you about three ways that you can answer people's questions and concerns. And also I wanted to give you a resource with lots of links and articles so that you can be fully resourced and informed about the situation. So here's my three tips about how to best answer parents' concerns. The first tip I have for you is this: don't be flippant in your response. You know, I've seen some people respond to people's questions with answers such as, well, everybody mines data, who cares? Google doesn't use it to target ads because ads are turned off in the student accounts, which is true. Or I've even seen people say, well, your child gives away more information on Facebook than Google could ever get from an email, so what are you concerned about? Now, my advice to you here is, don't just dismiss people's concerns because they're real concerns. And I understand that maybe you have a trust of Google and you trust them and you know that ads are turned off, and our resources will certainly point you to the links that show you that. But here my point is this: just take people's concerns to heart and do your best to communicate with them and hear and understand them and understand their problems. So point number two is this. You know, in psychology, they tell us that people fear loss more than they value gains. So when psychologists talk to us about this, what they're saying is that the fear of loss is a massive motivator for people. So if this is the case, my suggestion to you is not to then go on and talk about all the benefits of drive and collaboration and how fantastic a tool Google is, because they're really not interested in the gains they can get. What they're interested in is what is the potential for loss if this goes bad. So my encouragement to you here is to listen to their concerns, try and understand what they're concerned about losing, and then be able to answer those questions specifically. The third suggestion that I have for you in being able to answer people's concerns about student data and so on: be well resourced. If you're able to articulate the problem and the concerns that people might have better than even those people can, what this will do is it will position you as an expert. Because if I can explain the problem to you better than even you know the problem, then when I give you an answer, then what will happen is that they will expect that your answer is correct because you even know the problem better than them. So if you're watching this video on my blog, then just below you'll see a link to the resource. If you're watching this video on YouTube, just have a look in the description section below and you'll be able to see all those resources there. If you have any questions, then shoot me an email at mike@teacherstraining.com.au. And I'll certainly do whatever I can to help. So I hope you enjoy the resource and the documents and that your discussions become a little bit more fruitful. Until next time, I'll see you then.